Comrades, welcome back to the ongoing campaign to liberate the world. I'm Richie, playing From the Depths. Now, I decided we need to take out these two squares here, this 40 and 19, to consolidate my hold on their territory. So what I'm going to do for this is I'm going to detach the Norfolk from this fleet. And what I'm going to do I'll need to reconsolidate those later. Anyway, what I'm going to do is take the Norfolk south and add the Liverpool, the other light cruiser. So what I'll do is I'll build that, and once I've got those two ready in position, I'll get back to their place. And so here are my two light cruisers, the county class on the left and the town class on the right. The county class, the Norfolk, you've probably seen before. It's one with the advanced cannons, packs quite a good punch. It's also very similar to the town class as well, except you probably notice that the main guns on this one are crams as opposed to advanced cannons. Apart from that, it's pretty much functioning identical to the Norfolk. And with these two, I'm going to liberate these two tells now by first of all sending a Katyusha in to cross their territory. And we are up against Carcharodon, of course. We're going to be up against one of those, a zealot and another zealot. I'm pretty confident we can handle these anyway. We'll have a go and find out. And it looks like I've only got one spawning in because of the volume limits. But thankfully his shields are holding against him. So with any luck I can pick off one of these and then my other cruiser will spawn him. What on earth are you shooting out there? Oh, of course it's the wet shots bouncing off, isn't it? Those cram cannons are quite good when they hit, actually. Yeah, you see what I mean? Well, their accuracy might not be the best and might be a bit slow, but certainly pack out one hell of a wallop when they do hit. And getting airborne, which will make this a bit more interesting. And he's sailing off into the sunset. Okay, let's have a change of priority. Let's bring down this guy instead.
Engage now.
Unless the other one comes back first, which I don't think he is. I'm pretty sure these two aren't meant to be airborne, actually. Oh, that's beautiful. Yeah, crash and burn. So now I think it's just his buddy now and the Carcharodon to take down. And hopefully the Norfolk should spawn in at some point as well. Hopefully before the Carcharodon does. Yeah, this is the kind of thing I'd expect him to do more, really. He's grazed a bit of the side armor, but I'm still in fighting order. Oh crap, he's coming in for another ramming attack as well. Same place as well, yeah, so. Ouch, yeah, that does hurt. Thankfully, I should be able to stay floating for now until the repairs are complete and until I sink this guy. I've still got one of my batteries in play. Thankfully, my repairs are nearly complete. This is kind of bizarre the way it keeps flying around like that. I'm not sure. I really don't think it's supposed to be doing that. Still, I prefer him flying around up here rather than ramming into my ship. Come on, get him. Nice, that's beautiful. And he's going, looks like he's doing, might be coming straight back down to Earth. Thankfully he's gonna, should be missing my ship. Oh, nice, very nice. That might be it for him, actually. Yep, judging by the disintegration, he's done and dusted now. So it's just my two ships against the Carcharodon, I think it is. If I can just get a few shots from the crams in there, that should make a nice mess of him. Yep, like that. Beautiful. A few more missiles and a few more shots from the Norfolk. Trouble with them being so slow, it's hard to actually lay any fire on them. Thankfully the Norfolk's doing the brunt of the damage here, those advanced cannons. Just have the speed needed to bring down this thing. I think once he slows down a bit, I think the Liverpool should be able to finish him off. Yeah, looks like he's focusing on the Norfolk. I thought that was going to hit them. So close. No, don't fire those cannons at that angle. Thank you. Oh, nice. I think that's him done for. Yep, if we just get the crams to him, finish him off, that should be good night of Vienna for him. Yep, Norfolk thing brings him down. Liverpool finishes him off. Well, he's at the last theory anyway. And just one more towel in this sector to mop up, and then I can carry on pushing up and hopefully link up with my northern fleet. I think having these two work together is a good combination. So under cover of night, we'll launch an attack against the last of the southern fleet for the, southeastern fleet for the White Flayers. Again, I really don't see that thing. They're going to be a threat to me here. Well, as long as I just make sure the Norfolk spawns in. Although, with it being a small force, it should get both of them spawning in. And we're up against an Earthraker. Let's make the Norfolk the flagship spawning first. Norfolk can invade, can engage at that range, but unfortunately, the man Liverpool struggles a bit. However, once it closes in a bit, well, should change. He's actually surprisingly doing quite a bit of damage to the Norfolk. If he's got frag shells on board. Oh no, I think it's because he took out the cannon on top of it. Unfortunately, there's not an easy way to make cram cannons longer ranged. I mean, I can make the barrels longer and that should do it, but unfortunately it kind of makes it look a bit ridiculous, really. Or I could up the calibre a bit, but I don't want the Liverpool to have too high a calibre, to be honest. Excellent, so that's the last of the southern fleet, southeastern fleet taken out. So I'll now cheekily grab their territory. And I'll push east and westward. And I've just noticed we've got a fleet mobile in the Lightning Hood's territory. So we're going to get the Deliverance back into action. And we're up against, what have we got? Strider GL. A diode, another diode, and a sea raptor. Yeah, I don't think these should be too major a threat, actually. I'm gonna continuous laser from the Deliverance, managing to chop off massive chunks of him. Beautiful. Yeah, I think he's gonna be out of action pretty quickly. And I think this was the last mobile force for the Lightning Hoods, so once they're out of the way, should just be a straightforward case of mopping up with the Lightning Hoods. And for some reason they were moving really slow at 3 meters a second, which is why it's taken them so long to get into range. Yeah, I think his loft is starboard pylon, whatever it is. And looks like he's lost his lasers as well. He's still trying, I'll give him that, but I think at this point in the game he's not gonna be able to do much now. Just waiting for that starboard panel to detach on, or wait for him to disintegrate, one of the two. That works as well. And now his buddies are in dire straits at the minute, it looks like. He's dead, the other one's dead, it's just, yeah. I think that's it. I've got the limits just sat there refueling for now. Unfortunately, with him being the big massive brute it is, it needs time to refuel all his fuel tanks. So I'll leave him there for now to recharge. We're gonna get a lot more use when coming to mopping up the lightning hoods. So it's time to take out this 150 tile. I've got my cruiser fleet in place, and I've got my destroyer fleet in place as well.
Moving out.
So I think we should be able to handle what they can throw at us. I think these really are the end days for the lightning floods, the white flares. So let's get them tag teaming them. Let's see what we're up against. We've got Ripper, a Spike, again a Carcharodon, a Zealot, a Ripper, a Thresher, and a Martyr. So let's look at the build order. I think we want the Woolworth carrier in. We want to get those aircraft in if we can. Monitor, I think, is least priority. Liverpool would be nice. Probably above the Orion. But yeah, I think I'll... Shall we get the Cossack in above the Orion? Since he tends to do quite effectively. Or even raise a Cossack above the Liverpool. Since it'll shield the carrier. Yeah, I think that's a good lineup. Okay, let's get this show on the road then. Well, first of all, I need to get onto the ship itself. Thankfully, the Norfolk's deflecting most of his shots. I think. Oh, she's not actually. Could be he's got some frag shells on there. In which case, we'll need to take them down whichever crossfire knows as quickly as possible. Now, I think it's this, what's that one again? A Thresher. Yeah, get everything to focus on the Thresher, please. Preferably before we lose the Norfolk. I think once the torpedoes start hitting, though, that should slow him down a bit. He's like a supersized version of that the other cruiser we saw the other day. Yeah, that one there. Oh, well, thank you. Yeah, just ram your buddy. That'll help me a little bit. No, don't repair. That doesn't help me. Oh, nice. What a clutter klutz. One or two holes straight through the side. Yeah, I think he was using frag shells, actually. Which is why he was able to just punch straight through. Well, we should have a gun in here as well, which we don't. And here. Under the front as well. Yeah, Also, they did a bit more damage than I expected. And if we got all mosquitoes in play, yeah, we'd... get down to one mosquito in play. I think what'll happen is once that gets taken out, I'll withdraw the carrier and let it bring in another unit. Half shot to hell, but still fighting on. Yes, the downside to using the advanced cannons on a Norfolk, unfortunately, when they explode, they sometimes take down the other one as well. I've had this problem with a few battleships, I just need to space them out a bit more. Or use heavy armour on the turrets. Nice, that's beautiful. Does that put him out of action yet? Nope, he's still going. No, he isn't. Yep, he's done for now and out of action. Good riddance. Now, hopefully we'll get some more ships spawning in. I think the next to spawn will be, is it the Liverpool? If so, his missile should do a good job against the Carcharodon when it comes in. And I think that's it coming into play now. Okay, I might be better off just taking manual control of the Mosquito for now. There we go. Doesn't look like his weapons are functioning anymore. There is one thing for it though. Alright, but yep, totally worth it. 10 out of 10 would you get again? I think what I'll do now is I'll pull the carrier out of action since he's not able to contribute anything. And hopefully my display should clear a little bit. It's kind of frustrating when you get that oil coming on your screen. My ships are all at pretty good health now, actually. So, what I need to do is just keep chipping away at this guy. And hopefully he doesn't blow anything up on any of my ships. Let's see what he's up to health-wise. He's down to 81%, so it shouldn't take too long to take him down now. Just need a few more missile strikes, and then the cannons can pretty much finish him off. Yep, a few more hits like that will do him nicely. He's already lost half its cannons anyway, so it shouldn't take too much longer. I say optimistically. Oh, that's nice. I mean, I think half his internal components are probably shredded now. I think his fuel engine's starting to go there, just heard the popping from him. Yep, and I think that is it for him. Put up a long and brave fight against me. Hopefully once I link up with my Northern Fleet, I'll have the Nemesis to be able to join the fleet, and that should make short work of it. No, I doubt he lost some important bits there. No, a series of explosions. And yeah, rest in pieces. So, under cover of rain and thunder, or not, as it's just fading away, I'm going to take out that resource zone. Again, for some reason, Liverpool wants to spawn first, but no, we'll put a Norfolk in there.
Listening.
And get them both there, and we'll get this show on the road. I'll just transfer over to the Norfolk. And we'll take down this reason. And thankfully, he's using sabot shells, which are bouncing off rather nicely. I don't think I've been taking any damage either. Marginal damage. I think we can continue the offensive. And this should be another nice resource zone for us to capture. Yep, it looks like his cannon's down. Literally. And he's down. Yep, another victory for the forces of communism. And what we need to do is take out the defenders holding that square, which is going to be a bit more interesting.
Listening.
Okay, moving it's out. time to take that territory and capture that resource zone. So what I'll do, provoke the fleet again.
Moving out.
And drag them onto my cruiser and destroy your force. And let's see what we're up against. We have a Charon, I don't think I've seen that before. Carcharodon. A Zealot, Buzzsaw, Earthraker, Guillotine, and a Spike. I don't think that should be too significant. I think what I'll do this time is, I don't want a monitor in there, last, really. I want Liverpool to come in second, then Orion and the Cos. Yep, that looks like a good setup. So, let's get this show on the road. Thankfully, just using Sabbath shells mostly, I think. Oh, and those shells that knock them away as well. Yeah, those kind of shells are great against airborne targets, like they did, like you saw when they bounced my carrier into space. They're not so good against ground-based units, though, or sea-based units. But since you insist on using them, I'll make you a priority. And besides which, I really don't want those blades getting too close either. Can make a nasty mess of my ship if they do get close. The other ship, the Zealot's just diving into the water, rather asininely. And hopefully I can get my other ship, Liverpool, spawned in soon to help with the frame. He's got double layered shielding there or something. Oh, he has, hasn't he? It's just the way the shields are arranged. I'm guessing he hasn't got torpedo guards, though. Nope. And there he goes. So now we need to take you down. ASAP. I'm not sure if my guns have the elevation to get him, actually, at that angle. Watching it looks like I've lost my back cannons as well. What I can do though is jump out there and capture him. Find out where his AI is. This is not going well, actually. Okay, get back on the Norfolk. I'll try and do some repairs that way. And what I'll do is I'll lob grenades down onto him instead. That should get him off my back for a bit. Is upside down in the water. Can we get him right way up? He's trying, he's getting there. Damage took quite a bit of damage from him though. But thankfully with the captain in there, he's repairing rather quickly. How far did it push him away? A considerable way actually, all things considered. Yes, glorious, back on it. Back up on his keel. And what are the other enemy units doing? Not a lot. Looks like that Charon's sitting there dead in the water. So if I can just take this Zealot down, I might get more of my own forces spawning him. Hopefully before the Carcharodon arrives. Oh, that's nice. Seeing bits of him shredded away is always glorious sight. Even with just one cannon, still able to fight on. One cannon and a missile swarm, hopefully, at some point. Yeah, right on cue. Direct hit. Beautiful. And hopefully that should be the end of him. I think it is, actually. He might have taken out his AI there. Definitely taken out something. Judging by all those bits flying off him. And yeah, I think he's shredding to pieces. He's done for. Looks like my buddy's in back in place, so I'll move my ship back up to park up somewhere close to him. I think it might be time as well. I'll use my helicarriers a bit more. I've got an upgrade for the Courageous coming, plus I want to add another carrier to the fleet. I need to probably send them down to Lightning Hood's territory to start. Well, to carry on with my offensive down there once that kicks off. So, thinking ahead, yeah, I'll add another helicarrier, transfer a couple of the swordfish over, and add some Wildcat aircraft that can are good against ships and aircraft. I think four of those Wildcats and two swordfish. A good little all-round combination. Looks like Liverpool's taking a little bit of damage. Let's see, we'll transfer over there and help out with the repairs there. I think Norfolk's more or less in good nick. And it's a car carried on. He's dead in the water. Beautiful sight. I've got another ship coming into the fray as well. This is the Orion, my destroyer. I've actually got an upgrade due for him as well, so I better get that done after the battle. Yep, Liverpool is hammering away with those cram cannons. They're making nice big holes in him. And I think his dot is a goner. So, what else is there to come in our way? Is that the last of them? No, there's still one. It's a buzzsaw. And now we've got the Cossack in there as well, so I think it's a Cossack. Yeah, it's a Cossack. So against the fire of my four ships. Let's see, getting close and see how he does. I don't think he's got much of a chance, to be honest, but hey. Oh yeah, I really hate those things on in front of it when I get close. Come on lads, it's 4-1. Let's see if we can stop him dead in his tracks. Oh nice, that took away quite a bit of him. A few more shots like that. Yeah, looks like the torpedo's just finding his target there. And looks like he's trying to be a submarine. Instead, he can be a shipwreck. So after a little bit of work, I've now got two aircraft carriers in operation. I've got the Courageous on the left. I've added four Wildcats to it and two Swordfish. And on the right's a Furious with four Wildcats and two Swordfish. They're pretty identical to each other, except the Courageous have got the cram cannons and the Furious has got the advanced cannons instead. It should complement nicely or a little offensive against the White Flayers. So I think the only thing to do now is to give the Furious a test debut. See how well it performs in combat.
Moving out. Listening. Moving out. Moving out.
So we have the Furious up against the Jimnera. I think we can just about handle this, that we've got enough aircraft to do it with. So, without further ado, let's get the show on the road. Should we bring the helicarrier in to join the fray as well? Just make sure I'm not hogging the weapons controls. Is that two of them in there? Have I got two to face? Oh yeah, there's a little zealot tidy underneath it. Then look, it doesn't knock me into space like he did the other one. And the massive missile spam from the Wildcats doing gloriously there. I think most of my aircraft are focusing on the big one. So all I'll do is I'll bring my bring the Furious in there and lend a hand to them. We'll take down as many as we can if it's possible. Looks like the other one is dead in the water for now. So we'll probably just see doing this, we'll see him go right up. Yep, we'll see him go flying off into the sky again. Oh lovely, that missile spam just hammering home there. Which I think with combined with my cannons should be enough, more than enough to finish him off. I don't think we've taken any damage, let's have a look. One of the Swordfish is a little scratched, but other than that, everyone looks to be in good nick. And I think that's the end of him now, he's just going through his death throes now. So with him down, we just need to go and pick off his mate. And then that'll be another victory for us. Where is his pal anyway? Yeah, he's over there. And it looks like the missile spam's really hammering into him now. I don't think he'll be around for much longer now. Nope, and he's disintegrating. And a successful outing for the Furious' first combat debut. Looks like the White Flayers are pretty much on the last legs now. Let's say thank you for watching. We'll carry on mopping up what's left of them in the next episode. So like, comment and subscribe if you like what you've seen. And I'll see you then.